We're going to see if this works.
Streaming live from New York City.
I think it's working, by the way. It's working. I mean, it looks like I'm streaming.
Nope. It said loading video for a second, then it stopped.
Okay. Okay.
Now it says loading video again.
Okay, great.
Loading the video. Oh, there it is. Hey. I see Cavern Kings.
Yes. Good. It's working. We are now streaming live from New York.
New York City.
Nice. Nice. We're going to delete the second tweet here. If it's not working for you, refresh your page. Apparently, normally, when you're streaming through Twitch, you get to choose which server you stream through. And normally we stream through the Chicago server because obviously it's closest to Milwaukee. Hey, Rich, why don't you just talk a little bit so I can do a quick sound check?
Okay.
Sound check.
Say things about things, you know, like really deep things about feelings.
Great deep things.
Feelings and stuff, you know.
Those are good feelings. I'm hearing the sound check now. Oh, yeah, you sound great, Rich. Great. Normally we stream through Chicago. Apparently the Chicago servers are down right now, which is why we were having some issues streaming.
They're in mourning for the Bears.
Oh, did they do
poorly? They died today.
Oh, I apologize.
I didn't catch the final score. I stopped watching when it was 51-23?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's a fucking basketball score, not a football score.
Well, I'm sorry, all of Chicagoland, but...
What the fuck?
Oh, my God. What the fuck, indeed. Easter Puck, thank you for subscribing. We super appreciate it. So in any case, it wasn't going out through there, so we tried a server out of Dallas, and that's when everyone was having their problems. So now we are streaming through the New York server, which apparently is robust enough to handle this.
We have a subscriber shout-out.
I already did that.
Did you say it? Okay, you did that? Did I miss it?
I did it in the middle of my little thing. Were you not listening to
me? Oh, my God.
Here's the thing. You should give them
I'm talking to you. I'm talking to you and reading chat. That's the problem. That's the problem.
Rich has a hard time multitasking.
I do. Mr. Buck, thank you for subscribing.
So, for any of you who didn't get to hear the classy version of All-Star, I'm just going to play the beginning again. Because I love it. Just listen to this. It's great, Rich.
Somebody once told me the world is going to roll me.
You're not hearing it because you can't, but...
I ain't the sharpest one in the shed.
That's enough of that. I've now stopped playing the lounge singer version of All Star. It is by No Reply. If you go to SoundCloud and look up All Star Smash Mouth cover, the one by No Reply is the one. It's fantastic. Okay, so Cavern Kings. Look at this. Where is it?
Yeah.
What the fuck?
Oh my God. We got another what the fuck. Who is that? That's Katie Paper.
Katie Paper.
Katie
Thank Paper. You for subscribing. I beat you to it.
You did.
I beat you to it.
Son of a bitch, Rich. You son of a bitch. Okay. There's a couple things that I want to talk about before we get started playing. One, just how much I love Rich's reading of the aliens comment line, and how much I love that you guys love it. I'm really glad that all of you enjoy it. The thing I'm most happy about is that Let's Play guy, or Letty Play. It's not a Let's Play. He had a typo in the name of his YouTube channel.
What the fuck?
It's T. Hey, Waffling. Waffling. Thanks for subscribing. We super appreciate it. So it's TGG Letty Play, not Let's Play. L-E-T-Y Play. I know, right?
Isn't that guy amazing?
He's the most fantastic.
Isn't he? He wanted us to take that video down.
He told us to delete the video.
He can go fuck himself. Because that should stay up forever.
I just want to make sure that everyone understands that if you make...
What the fuck?
Oh my god. There's another one. What was that one?
Severedo. Severedo. Ooh. Thank you for subscribing.
We super appreciate it. When you make a comment in a public forum, like the YouTube comments, that's out in the public. So we get to do whatever we want with it. oh, man. And, you know, hopefully we can help. I think when we do our charity live stream, it will be for cancel research. Because that was his other big typo, right? It gave him cancer.
Yeah, well, he deleted that too, right? That's no longer...
Oh, did he?
I think so. I could be wrong. Like, I could read more comments, but none of them are going to be as good as that.
That's really true. Oh, and by the way, Kager, the reason I'm so confused by people subscribing is because every time someone subscribes now, I get Rich saying, "What the fuck?" in my ears, and so I'm momentarily startled. which is why I sound confused every time.
What the fuck?
See, just like that. Just like that.
Biff Meat Slab, thank you for subscribing.
That's a great name, Biff Meat Slab. We super appreciate the subscription. In any case, Rich and I threw together that little Rich Reads YouTube comments video before last Wednesday's stream, and I'm just happy that you guys have enjoyed it, because I enjoy it. What else are we going to talk about? I'm going to get started on Cavern Kings.
I look like shit in that video, though.
Well, the thing everyone needs to understand about that video is Rich was napping minutes before.
We just had an early morning that day with Space Cop stuff. And I had like 3 hours of sleep that night because I'm a night owl, and I had to get up at the early hour of 9 a.m. So I didn't get much sleep, and so I was taking a nap before the stream, and then Jack showed up.
That's right.
Just kind of wakes me up. It's like, "We're going to film this video." I'm like, "What?" What?
That's true. Oh, that's right. And everyone, welcome our new moderator, John Kilo 3. John Kilo has been with us since the beginning, and every once in a while, OctoJ apparently has something better to do, which is fine. And so we've donned a new moderator, John Kilo, to watch after y'all, because if it's anything we learned from last Wednesday's stream, is you guys can get a little crazy.
Yeah, apparently we need mods, badly.
We need mods, and so we really appreciate John Kilo stepping up, and OctoJ, all of your help. OctoJ recommended John Kilo. Hold on, I'm just going to make sure that the game audio is... You can hear that. I'm just making, like, little bleepities. Okay, great. Okay, by the way, the main character, I don't know if you've noticed, Rich, the main character of this game is named Jack, so I immediately...
Okay.
I know nothing about Cavern Kings. I literally know nothing about this game, but the developers of this game sent it to me. And they said, we think you would like this. And so, oh my god, this is a weird control scheme. And so they said, we think you'd like this. Do you want to play it? And I said, sure. Does it have controller support? Because that's always my number one concern.
Oh, Jack.
Does it have controller support? And they said it does, and it does. And here's the weird thing. It's right bumper to jump.
Okay.
Right bumper to jump. So it's a twin stick.
Well, that makes perfect sense then if you're using a twin stick.
Well, it's like a twin stick shooter.
Would you rather let go of the stick to jump? That seems like a logical solution to me.
By the way, Rich, touche. You're absolutely right. Okay, I got a jackhammer. I'm learning how to play the game live. I got a jackhammer. That's weird. So jump is right bumper. To use the jackhammer is left trigger. Strange. Very strange. This is very strange, Rich.
Okay. So far, you're just pointing a thing around on the screen. I can't see you using that thing yet, so...
Oh, sure. Sure. It's just very strange.
It's weird for me to pay attention to the game when you play because there's such a lag.
Sure.
So, yeah, sure, it's fine.
Yeah.
It's all fine.
I mean, I get it. I'm supposed to go down this tunnel, but I just kind of want to fuck around with this jackhammer some more. So it is a roguelike. You have one life to complete the game, because that is the definition of roguelike. And it's also... What? Oh, it's also randomized. So, okay, right trigger shoots the other thing you have. Oh my god, this is great. It's also randomized. So every time you play, you're going to get different weapons and different levels. Mm-hmm. And right now I'm facing little eyeball monsters with hard hat helmets on. So I'm kind of loving it.
Okay.
Just because right now it's so cute. Oh, and there are spikes.
Jack, don't all games seem better since we played Alien Isolation, though?
That's really true.
I mean, isn't that the case?
Yes, and I know everyone is going to call me a hipster or whatever because I'm playing a 2D side-scroller with pixel graphics. Watch me not give a fuck is what I'm going to say. Because you know what, this seems so far to be like a game.
These are better games to stream, I think.
Yeah, I did. Over the past couple of days, like there has been so much. Oh, okay. Oh my god, I leveled up. Great. I have no idea what I'm doing or what's happening. Everyone should know. I just keep going down. I assume that's the correct course of action. I have been watching some people stream Alien Isolation.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, just to see, like, what do normal people think about this game?
Yeah.
Because apparently we are not normal.
That's fine. I'm fine being not normal. I've been not normal most of my life.
Nice.
But, I mean, are they scared?
No, they're not scared. In fact, like the one stream that I saw, that this guy seemed to have like a lot of viewers and people seemed to like all the things he was saying. He was getting really pissed off at the game.
Oh, really?
Because of how hard it was and how bullshitty it was. And
it's not like it's hard. The problem is it's tedious. Hiding in a closet. That's the game. Hide in the closet. You're playing the game. You're doing nothing. You're sitting here doing nothing.
Yes, it's...
Because the alien randomly showed up in the room you were in, so now you gotta do nothing for 5 minutes.
But it's not only tedious, it's tedious... E to purchase? Can I do that? No, I can't. Okay. It's not just tedious, it's tedious and kind of bullshit. Like, because the alien will just do whatever it feels like doing. There's no game to it. There's very little game to the game.
Yeah.
Not to harp on Alien Isolation more.
It could work if the experience and immersion worked, but they don't.
Right. That's the thing. That, like, I wish there was a good story. I do, because then I would have enjoyed it.
either give me a game or an experience, but I don't think neither is acceptable.
That's great, Rich.
I mean, you know, it's like the Stanley Project. That's, Stanley, I mean, not Parable. Project. I keep saying Project. The Stanley Parable.
Yeah.
That's not, that's not really a game, but it's interesting.
Yes. It's like a commentary on games, and it's great. Yeah. No, some games have a good story or a good atmosphere, and that's fine. This had nothing. Shit. What is happening? Oh my god.
I don't know. People are saying they can barely hear you.
They can barely hear me.
Jack's audio is too low and the game's is too high.
Great. All right, hold on.
You people complain about Jack, and now you want to hear him.
When I was playing, I moved away from the microphone a little bit.
Okay.
So hold on, I'll turn my mic up a little bit. There's my mic, and I will turn the game down. Hold on, how do I do that? Okay. The game is now turned down. I am turned up, and I'm close to the microphone, hopefully.
Okay.
So where you guys can hear me. I have no idea what is happening in this game. Is a real thing. Oh, I just died. I just died, apparently.
Well, that's fantastic.
That's great. Okay, I didn't get any power-ups.
You don't know what you're doing in the game?
I have no idea what I'm doing.
So what you're saying is you're running on pure instance. Is that what you would say?
That's exactly what I would say.
Okay.
I'm using my gamer instance, and I'm trying to don't about stuff I don't like. Oh, I got a shovel this time instead of a jackhammer.
It's never going to get old, is it?
It's so beautiful.
3 years from now, I'm going to be calling people crocodile brain.
As you should.
It's never going to get old.
That's fine.
Does my laughter cure cancel? I got cancer down. I can cure cancer, but I don't know about cancel.
Absolutely. That's really funny. Whoever said that, congratulations on being super funny. Okay, I think I'm getting what this game is all about, which is very exciting for me.
What is it about, Jack?
I have no idea. I said I think I'm getting it. I don't have it. Oh, okay.
I'm just watching a tiny square shoot at eggs.
Yeah, that's what I'm doing so far. That's the game.
Did you lose your jackhammer?
Yeah, this time I got a shovel.
Okay.
Random weapon assignage.
Okay.
This time I have a shovel and a nail gun so far. And I don't know if it's better, maybe worse, I don't know.
I
got a thing. I can periodically throw knives now. So we got that going for us. Oh, I can just hold down the trigger button. That's good to know. Oh my god. Yeah, so this is very, like, very Risk of Rainy. If this is very Risk of Rainy on a NES.
So what's to keep you from just continuously digging down? Why bother messing around with enemies?
Good question. I assume... Yeah, okay, so enemies level me up. They make me more powerful.
Okay.
And then I collect these little gems after I kill them, and I assume those gems will be used for something at some point. Oh yeah, like here, I can purchase this thing, which I just did. Oh, okay, I just purchased a thing that leaves a trail of fire. So that's good, but now I move hella slow. Oh, but that's really... I just said hella, also. I'm not necessarily proud of that, but, you know, I did, so what are you gonna do?
Nothing. Absolutely nothing.
That is the correct answer, Rich. Oh, I died. Okay, I'm not very good at, like, managing my health, apparently.
Uh-huh.
Jack should play Alien Isolation, you're right.
Oh, God. I traded that in and I have no regrets. I never, ever trade in anything. Mm-hmm.
No, you know, the one good thing about Alien Isolation is when I bought it, there was a promotion. So I got a TF2 scout outfit.
Yeah. Yeah.
And I'm really excited about that.
You have the Steam version, so you're not trading anything in anyway.
Nope. Oh my god, this is a cool weapon. I have like a little buzzsaw shooter. That's cool. I like that. I'm down with that. I'm down with that.
What the fuck?
Chat wants to know what you think of Sonic the Hedgehog.
Well.
Heathington, thank you for subscribing.
If only there was some sort of video that we made chronicling my distaste for Sonic the Hedgehog. Oh, but you know what? Much like Alien Isolation, we were just playing it wrong.
Yeah.
So, we should have known better. We should have rolled, is the thing. Oh my god, I might die here. Right here, right now. Nope. Okay, I didn't. Great, great. Everything's great. Everything's great. Oh, this buzzsaw gun is awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm really digging this buzzsaw gun. Yeah, Sonic the Hedgehog. I don't get it. I don't get it. And I don't think that any of our complaints would have been fixed if we would have rolled. So, there you have it, people. The thing, you know what bothers me the most? This is something I wanted to talk about like the Alien Isolation comments. Something that bothers me the most about those comments is people saying that our views were contrary just to be contrary.
That is so not true.
You guys have no idea how much we wanted to like this game. We
like Alien.
Yes.
You know?
We are fans of Alien. The Alien universe. And like all of the things. Like I left in all of that stuff about us like enjoying just walking around the alien ship on purpose, you know? To show people how much we like the Alien universe. But no, we were just doing it to be contrary. Just to get the views, Rich. Come on, TNT, blow up.
Why is it with movies, people love it when you hate on things? But with video games, they expect you, they love it when you love things.
Yeah.
When you gush all over a game.
I don't.
But a movie, it's, people love negative reviews. Why is that?
You know, I think it has to do with how old the medium is, and games are still pretty young. It's something we need to remember about games in general. They are still a relatively young art form. So, a lot more people
get. It's a 40-year-old art form at this point, Jack.
Sure, but not as old as movies. Relatively young.
Okay. Okay.
Be with me here. Be with me here. Relatively young. And even though it's 40 years old, it hasn't been as big as it is now, you know. Now it's much more popular than it once was. There's a thing. Bigger bullets, bigger damage. Shit, yeah. Okay, alright. Alright, I'm digging it. I'm digging it. Gotta get out of here. There's this like buzzsaw. I don't know if you're seeing like the spikes on top here. That make you... It's nice. It's a nice touch. It's a little.
So there are spikes in this game.
There are spikes in this game. I don't know if Phoenix has shown up yet to ask if there are spikes in this game, but there are indeed spikes in this game. And much like, I know you haven't played Spelunky. One day I'd like to play Spelunky on the stream. I really love Spelunky.
Sure.
Much like Spelunky, if you spend too much time on a level, there's a little... In Spelunky, there's a ghost. And the ghost comes and gets you if you spend too much time on a level. And, you know, kind of gives you that sense of... hurry the fuck up.
Yeah. I'm assuming the next... Oh, sorry. Finish your thought. Sorry.
Oh, and so this has little spiky dealies, which do the same thing, and I enjoy that. Sorry. I'll finish. Go ahead.
No. I mean, I'm assuming the next stream we're doing Dr. Mario.
Yes. We have, Mike really wants us to do a Dr. Mario stream, and so I believe... I don't know if we can do Wednesday, but our next group stream will be Dr. Mario to please Lord Michael.
Right. I was thinking maybe... How do you feel about the Stanley Parable?
I mean, I like the Stanley Parable. We've talked about this. I don't know if it would be a good stream.
Was it too much of a spoiler?
It would
to play that game?
It would be. It would all be spoilers, because that's the game. You can't play it without spoiling it.
That's one... I don't know. Jay might find that amusing.
I think Jay should play it in general.
Yeah. He wouldn't play it unless it's a stream.
Right. Great. Yeah, and so I don't know, like that's oh man, I'm gonna die. No, don't die, I'm really enjoying. Really enjoying this run, don't die yet. Yeah, please help.
Maybe like a Dead Rising. I don't know if you ever played Dead Rising.
I didn't play Dead Rising.
Well, Dead Rising's great.
I hear great things about that game. Yeah, I just looked at the chat and someone was saying, don't stream Stanley. It's not a streamable game.
Okay.
The stream won't be Stanley. It will be...
Yeah, because we'd have to talk over it. And if you don't hear the narrator... Yeah, that's a good point.
Oh, my. The stream would be Jay. But, yeah, we'd have to take so many breaks from talking to people just to listen to the wonderful game, you know?
Right.
So, I'm going to say we shouldn't.
I agree.
You reluctantly agree?
Yeah. Well, the Stanley Parable is one that, you know, anybody in this chat, anybody watching who has not played the Stanley Parable, please take a look at that game.
Yes. If you are a fan of games, this nails it. This nails metagames perfectly. Get up there. I know this is in beta still. This game is in beta. Cavern Kings. It's in such beta that Twitch didn't know it existed.
Okay.
Twitch
okay.
does not know that Cavern Kings exists.
Is this on Steam, or did he just send like you a copy that he had?
I'm playing on Steam. He sent me a code. The developer sent me a copy because he thought he saw our Risk of Rain.
Yeah.
And thought that I would enjoy it. And so far, I really am enjoying it. Full eye, in case anyone...
I can't comment too much because I'm not getting, you know, first-hand experience, so...
Right. Oh, right. I mean, it's... You know what it is? It's... And this is going to sound like a negative, and it might be. It's a smaller Risk of Rain.
Yeah.
That's exactly what it is, and it doesn't have Risk of Rain's style. You know, obviously it has its own style.
Well, it's got its own style, and that's a fine thing.
Yeah, exactly, exactly. Oh, yeah, I didn't mean that as a negative. I meant...
Yeah, okay.
I meant it doesn't look like Risk of Rain, which, take that for however you will, you know.
Risk of Rain isn't a twin stick.
Risk of Rain is not a twin stick, you're right. Everything I say is wrong all the time. Confirmed. Everything Jack says is wrong all the time. Risk of Rain is not a twin stick.
I'm just, you know, pointing out things that are different.
No, that's fine. You point them out. You point them out. And you know what I'm going to be? I'm going to be over here not giving a fuck. Oh, shit. Okay, what else did I want to talk about today? I talked about how, like, the people in the comments, right? What did I talk about? People were saying... There's a new comment... Oh, you know what? People were accusing me of not playing the game. Because on Steam, it only shows that I have 11 hours played.
Oh, for Alien Isolation?
For Alien Isolation.
Yeah.
And while it's true I only played 11 hours on Steam... Rich and I played at the studio on his PS4. And so, like, I didn't finish on Steam, but I played enough of it. Damn goblins.
Yeah, we played it ourselves for days.
Yeah, we each put in, like, 10, 15 hours on our own.
Yeah.
And then we played it together to solidify our discussion before the discussion. Which is
we played for 5 hours together, something like that. It was a while, right?
We played like 6-7 hours together. We played for a ridiculous long time. Or it at least felt like a ridiculously long time.
That's the problem with that game.
Yeah. Which is the other part of the review, because I know I do say two things that can be confusing to people who don't pay attention. Which is that we played separately, and then later I talk about playing at the studio.
Yeah.
As if you can have it one way or the other, but we did both. Oh, that was dumb.
And incidentally,
yeah.
How many hours do you have to play a game before you know whether or not you hate it?
Yeah.
are you really obligated to play a game for 20 hours before you can decide whether or not you're enjoying the experience?
I'm glad we did, because that means that we got to give it the full review. You know.
Uh-huh.
But no, for someone who wasn't reviewing it, no, I think they would know way sooner. That, of course, they loved it, because it's a brilliant game, right? Brilliant game.
Yes, Chad, I've heard that Zero Punctuation loved the game. Zero Punctuation is a different person.
It's true.
With different feelings and different thoughts and different experiences in life.
Yahtzee's personal experience dictates how he feels about a game, about any art in general. And I'm okay with that. I'm surprised. Oh, fuck. There's a kickback on that harpoon. Knocked me into some buzzsaws. I was shocked. I watched his review, as I watch all of his reviews.
Uh-huh.
And...
What did he say about it? I haven't seen it yet.
I mean, he praised a lot of it. He praised the atmosphere. Yep. He praised...
Why did the atmosphere completely fail for both of us? Are we the only two people on the planet and it's a huge coincidence?
Right? That's a good question. That's a good question, Rich. Is it because we are also movie people?
Maybe? I don't know.
You know, and it's like... I cannot answer that question. I wish I would be able to answer that question. But it's true, and Rich and I are very different gamers.
Yes!
Which is the double surprising thing, and both of us had very, very similar feelings on it. Ugh. But and that's fine. Like, I don't But here's the real thing about Yahtzee liking Alien. I don't begrudge him as a critic.
Yeah.
He is allowed to have whatever feelings he wants to have about anything. That's kind of the thing. And if he wants to like it, good for him. If it ever comes to like a conversation that we have, which we will never have, I will disagree with him. And that's fine. And then we will both go, oh, that's weird. We have a disagreement. That's fine. Because I can only imagine he's a reasonable person, unlike some of the YouTube comments we've gotten.
See, and my tastes tend to run parallel with his. Usually when he likes a game, I like it too. Mm-hmm. Like, Yahtzee's a big Thief fan. Yahtzee likes No More Heroes. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. We tend to like a lot of the same things. Mm. That makes it doubly interesting to me.
Agreed. I am with you. These spikes to kill people for me, which is nice. Oh, okay, I get it. I can kill these guys with my shovel. Yeah, very interesting. But also, beyond Yahtzee, Rich and I were baffled that anyone gave this game a good review. After we were done filming the episode, we both looked up what other critics thought about it, and we're just like, what?
We had strong opinions.
Strong opinions. So strong that I am baffled that anyone likes the game.
Yeah.
And again, that's fine if you do. You do what you do. That doesn't mean I won't be any less baffled. I suppose I'm equally as baffled by other people liking this game as they are by us liking it. So.
Not liking it.
Not liking it.
Yeah.
Sure. You're absolutely right.
Very, very important distinction.
An unfortunate Freudian slip. Ah, get out of here. The controls, I wish, and I, you know, the game's in beta. Configurable controls would have been really nice.
So what do you hate control-wise?
There is so much jumping and shooting at the same time, and the jump button is right bumper and shoot is right trigger.
Okay, so it should have been left and right.
But
what you think?
But left is your melee.
Okay.
Left trigger is your melee. And so yeah, it just needs, I don't know, you know, I don't know how you fix that. I don't know if you do, because it's a twin stick.
You play with the keyboard and mouse.
You play with the keyboard and mouse, absolutely. That's exactly how I fix it, Rich. You're right. or, you know, you could just also shut the fuck up. That's a that's a thing you could do as well. Out of here, rock monster. Rock monsters. It was a rock monster. That's a B-52's reference.
Right? Yeah, rock lobster. Yeah. It's a lobster. All right.
Yeah. Oh, fuck. The other thing I'm not necessarily digging about this game.
Is that a pun?
Oh my god, that wasn't a pun.
It should have been.
I'm so upset that wasn't a pun. Damn it, Rich, you're making me look like an idiot.
Well, you should have just ran with it, Jack. You said, yes, that was. That was most certainly, assuredly a pun.
Yes, that was a well-thought-out pun. No, I'm... Most assuredly a pun, absolutely. No, the thing I am not liking about this game right now is I'm unsure what my final objective is. You know, I have no idea if I am progressing how close I am to any sort of objective.
Are there cutscenes you skipped? Because that usually explains these things.
No.
Okay.
No, I have not. I have not skipped any cutscene. So no, it's just I have no idea what's happening. Which is fine. Dang ass. Dang, 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 dang. Dang! Everything's terrible. Or great, depending on how you look at it, I suppose. Here we go. Oh no.
Can you guys think of any Alien Isolation puns? Alien Isolation sucked! I tried.
That was you trying?
Yeah.
Oh my god, Rich.
Alien Isolation is a miserable experience! That's not quite a pun.
No, that's not a pun. In fact, that's not a pun at all.
No?
Alien Isolation, more like...
Alien, fuck you!
Perfect. Nailed it. More like Alien, fuck you.
More like Alien Irritation.
Ooh, there you go. Yeah. That's it. Alien Isolation isolated me from my feelings.
Junkfist says, Alien Isolation should be put in solitary.
Ooh.
There you go, you got it!
Nailed it. This is why Rich and I aren't very good at our jobs.
This is why you should be watching something else right now.
Yes.
Yeah.
Previously recorded, the stream where we encourage you to watch something better. Here, get over here.
Lord Savick says something that's probably true. You really can't aim with the controller.
And this game?
Just
in general.
In general. But I think he's talking specifically about this game.
It's a little difficult.
That seems like that makes sense to me.
It is not necessarily designed for a controller, but I think I'm doing all right. I feel like I'm doing all right. Or not, I don't know. It's fine. Everything's gonna be fine. Maybe. I should do more damage to a rock monster. A jackhammer should do more damage to a rock monster. Just...
Probably.
Just putting that out there. Shit.
Gonna die. You having trouble doing damage?
Well, I was... Yeah. I don't know. I don't know if I quite get this game yet. I know that I enjoy it, is all I can tell you.
How long did it take to get Risk of Rain?
What?
How long did it take to get Risk of Rain?
Immediately.
Yeah?
Yeah, I immediately got Risk of Rain. It took me a while to figure out like whether or not I was into it, but I got it.
Okay.
Got it immediately. Oh, yes. I like this gun. We can deal with this. Spamming saw blades. We can deal with this. What else can we talk about here to make it fun and interesting for those watching? I can talk about... I know we've kind of been a little callous about this, but I do today, and if we don't do it now, eventually I do today want to talk about the AVGN movie.
Oh, okay.
I
think the chat might have a heart attack when they hear that.
I really do. I have some things I would like to say about it, and you know, we've been saying we're going to talk about it for a while, and I've been kind of waiting for Jay to be ready to talk about it, and, you know, I'm just going to do it. I'm just going to do it because I have some things I want to say about it. So I don't know if people want that now or later. You know, we'll talk.
Oh, Jack.
I know. That's terrible. Mean. That was mean.
That's what that's what they get for hating you.
Okay. Are you guys ready? You're reading the chat, Rich. Are they ready for official AVGN?
Yes, discussion? They're ready. There's finally with like 10 Ys at the end of it.
Jesus Christ. Okay, so here's the preamble to the AVGN nerd. AVGN, not Angry Video Game Nerd. Shit, that's really E button. Also this, I need to actually press the E button to open that chest, even though I'm using a goddamn controller. The preamble is this. I am an internet person. I'm a person who makes videos on the internet.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore, I am incredibly interested in other internet people who make movies, as I am an internet person who wants to make movies.
Yes.
Therefore, any internet person who also makes a movie, I am interested in and rooting for. Because that's the thing I want. That's what people should know. Ooh, something neat happened. Other examples before we get into AVGN. This is the preamble. Picnic Face is a comedy troupe that started on the internet. They made a great movie called Roller Town. If anyone remembers Bobby Hacker, he's the guy who had that internet video, Get Out Your Fucking Checkbook, an internet video I enjoy. Also called Cars. I want to say like it was called Cars. He made a movie called Cars 3, actually. He was legally able to make a movie called Cars 3, which is hilarious. In its own right. But, you know, again, an internet person who made a movie, and, you know, like, Roller Town is a phenomenal movie. Cars 3 is exactly the kind of movie you expect Bobby Hacker to make. And apparently there's a fun story behind it. But, you know, like, I pay attention to these things, and I'm aware of these things. And so I was aware of the AVGN movie, even though I've only seen a couple of his episodes, you know?
Yeah.
And I'm not too into his style of humor. You know, I'm not into the poopy fart joke. Or I mean, I like the poopy fart joke, but just saying poopy fart is not enough of a joke for me.
The chat couldn't see it, but I did raise an eyebrow.
Oh, yeah. No.
I did raise an eyebrow.
I like poopy fart jokes, but he seems to just say poopy fart, and that's the joke.
Yeah.
And I'm not into that. As you should. You should raise an eyebrow, absolutely.
I feel the same way about the Angry Video Gamer.
Okay,
the gimmick got old quickly for me.
Yeah, but you know, he's been on the internet for a while. You know, he's an important figure. So I watched the movie with genuine like wonder, and it's like, okay, internet guy. He raised a ton of money.
Oh, incidentally, Jack, the chat is saying this from the guy who made the PP song.
Yeah, they're getting there. They're getting there. And that's fine.
Yeah.
That's fine. I think they see where I'm going with this, which is the real thing. Which is, I thought the movie was really, really bad.
Yeah.
The AVGN movie was far worse than I ever could have imagined. Especially from someone who seems to know what they're talking about when it comes to movies and narrative structures. It was a mess. It was a mess of a movie, a mess of characteristics. Everything about it was just terrible, to the point where I had to double check I was watching the right movie at one point. Like, oh, did he make a different movie, and is this just a movie starring him? Like, what is going on? You know? Like, I was generally dumbfounded by how terrible it was. It seemed to be the worst kind of fan service, and not even fan service. It was all like self-service, you know, like everything about the movie just made it seem like he was incredibly cool.
So it was like a gas station.
Oh,
self-service. No, no, never mind.
That's a fine joke, Rich. That's fine.
No.
No, I mean,
if it doesn't hit, it's not a fine joke.
Touche, motherfucker. Touche. You know, there seemed to be an ego about him as a character. And in the movie, for anyone who doesn't know, he plays the angry video game nerd. You know, like, he's not playing a character. It's not just a movie that he wrote and is starring in. He is playing the angry video game nerd.
Mm-hmm.
And it starts off baffling almost immediately when he has, like, a friend, and all he and his friend talk about are how nerds don't have friends. It's like, but you're a friend. And so it's like, not only... So that's crazy baffling. Hold on, I gotta hit this button here. So that's really baffling. But then everywhere he goes, people seem to like he goes to an arcade at one point, right? And everyone's like giving him high fives, and like he's the coolest guy in town, but he's supposed to be this like antisocial nerd character. Self-proclaimed antisocial nerd character, but everywhere he goes, everyone loves him. And so it's just like, what? I gotta get out of here. Shit. The story makes no sense. It looks fine. It looks like it was shot competently, you know.
Mm-hmm.
It looks a little bit like cheap video at some points, but I thought it looked fine. But just everything story-wise, execution-wise, was dumbfoundingly bad. It's been a while since I've seen it. It's been like a month or two since I've seen it, so I don't know if I can go into like super specifics.
Mm-hmm.
I know there's like this girl character, and her character is literally girl. Like that's all she has. She's like, I'm girl. I'm here. Someone is gonna fall in love with me. As it turns out, the person that fell in love with her was the friend, not the angry video game nerd. And she served her purpose as girl, but there was no character build up to like them falling in love. All of a sudden, like he rescued her at one point, and it was just like, I guess we're in love now.
Well, that's how you write a female character.
Yeah,
that's,
the man
that's
the
how
man
you
rescues
do it.
Her. The man rescues her, and I guess they're in love now. That was exactly what happened. They had no chemistry before that. They had no like lead up, no build up to their like relationship. It was just like at the very last minute he decides to rescue her from a giant robot thing, and they were in love now, I guess. It was shamefully bad.
Hmm.
Yeah. Have you seen it yet, Rich?
No.
Okay.
I don't see any reason to.
That, yes.
I've heard nothing but bad things.
I do wonder like how, because it was fan funded. Did he Kickstart or did he Indiegogo or something?
One or the other.
And so I do wonder like how his fans feel about it. I'm sure they like it because you know they like him.
I mean, is he doing a shtick in the movie? That might be all they want.
Maybe, I don't know.
Does he take time to badmouth the ET game?
He does. That's in fact. Yeah. Because that's the premise of the movie, for anyone who doesn't know, is he wants to find the ultimately bad thing because he's never done a review of the E.T. game for Atari. And the entire end credit sequence is his review. Oh, I think I hit a boss. I'm at a boss. Oh, my God.
That's horribly exciting.
It really is, I think, except for I'm going to die.
Stop talking and play boss.
Okay, play boss. Shit!
Metal earthworm.
Right?
Some sort.
Very risk of rain. Like even...
You know, there are worse games to be inspired by.
Oh, yeah, no, I'm not saying that as a negative, but like, if you look at the power-ups here, when they come up in a second, there's like an eyeball, there's a boxing glove, you know, like all of the, even the items look like they were maybe a little too heavily inspired by Risk of Rain.
Yeah. So you hated 3D Dot Game Heroes.
I did. I really did.
You actually hated it. That's shocking to me.
It's not.
I thought that game had Jack written all over it.
It's not a normal kind of hate, Rich.
Okay.
Hold on, wait. Let's wrap up Angry Video Game Nerd.
Yeah.
Before we move on to
E.T. game.
So that's the whole premise of the movie, is he's going to Nevada to dig up the buried E.T. game. And the entire end credit sequence is him masturbating.
Normal episode?
Is him masturbating. Not a
normal episode. Oh.
Because it's just him doing a normal episode, absolutely.
Okay.
I thought you meant
that literally.
Oh, God. No, but he's doing it in front of a crowd of people as they are cheering and laughing at all of his jokes, even though they're all actors, you know?
Like, yeah.
And they're doing this for, you know, the 10th take. Pure masturbation. I saw in the chat briefly that someone said, like, they weren't expecting it to be great, and it met those expectations. But they are, in general, a fan of his videos. And yeah, I guess we've talked about this before. Like, I've seen a couple of them. It's not really my thing. I mean no disrespect towards him. His videos just aren't my thing. But the movie... I think I can say for sure I have some disrespect towards that. Oh my god. Oh, I get it. This is an ice level. So when I shoot my gun, I go sliding back because it's an ice level.
That's
neat. You know what that is? Neat.
Son
of a bitch. There goes that aim. There goes that controller aim right there. You'll see in a second. I really
have
fun aiming in general and specific at a thing I was specifically trying to hit. Whatever. Okay. So 3D Dot Heroes. We are now over AVGN Nerd. In a moment I'll take a little break and talk to you guys about AVGN Nerd and how I really hated the movie.
Talk to us about the lessons of life.
I will talk to you about the lessons of life. 3D Dot Heroes. If 3D Dot Heroes would have given me anything that wasn't Zelda, I think I would have been much more comfortable with it.
You might not have been. I mean, you know, you skip all dialogue in that game. It does have like a sense of humor that the Zelda games don't.
Sure. Okay. Then maybe.
Okay.
I don't know. Like, it's just so... It was too much Zelda. It was too much Zelda for not a Zelda game. You know? Like, and there's a fine line between homage and just making Zelda. And we talked about that somewhat on the stream, but Jesus Christ. That took it too far, Rich. Took it too far. That's my line.
That's right, Samurai Quap. It gave you a shark-vomiting sword.
That's true. But only because that was our joke. That was neat. Like, creating your own character, sure, that was neat. That was all well and neat, but not enough. Too much. Too much Zelda.
Lord Savick says, Jack skipped the non-Zelda parts and complains about the lack of non-Zelda parts.
It's true.
Which I think is true.
It's true. Here's my only defense is that I don't think that would have helped the case. As I don't, in general, care about story. So, the story is different, you know.
Mm-hmm.
In my mind, that doesn't make much of a difference. Get out of here. But yes, you're very clever for pointing that out, whoever that was that pointed that out. Or not clever, observant, or whatever. I don't know. You're something. I don't know. Leave me alone. Oh, I'm gonna die again. I'm going to die again. Ooh, I'm not gonna die. Hooray! I gotta get out of here. Go get it. Okay, I'm getting out of here. I don't like this level. Yeah, I don't know, Rich. I can't. A line needs to be drawn at homages and 3D.heroes. I found it. That's a question for all times. Can you find your line? Shit. Come on. And I found it.
I enjoyed the game quite a bit.
Yeah.
Admittedly, I did enjoy it as a throwback to the classic Zelda games.
Sure. As I'm sure you're supposed to.
And I, you know, even though the gameplay was near identical, it does have its own style, its own sense of humor.
Yeah, no, oh, and the art style was super great.
Oh, plus it has the best tower defense minigame I've ever played.
It had a tower defense minigame?
There's a tower defense minigame in 3D.heroes that I just love.
Jesus. I don't know. I don't know about that. You're not selling me on it more. tower defense minigame. No, it's like I could have watched just the characters crumbling apart after you hit them. I could have watched that all day. That was super great. I love that.
Mm-hmm.
The art direction of it was fantastic. Just the everything is a Zelda thing. Everything is a Zelda thing. That's really funny. Oh, that actually makes it super badass. I just got a power up that bolsters aiming ability, and it's just a laser scope, but it's very helpful. when you have a controller, it's very helpful.
Here. Whatever works for you, Jack.
It's working. It's working for me, Rich.